Have you had an encounter with the King of the Forest? If so, I want to hear about it. And so does everyone else. What are you waiting for? Go on, put all the details down in an email and send it to me at contact@buckeyebigfoot.com. I'll be waiting. Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot. Hello there, everyone. Now, the weather here in the Ohio Valley, well, it's just perfect for our night ride down into Sasquatch Valley. And we're going to have some clear skies and very comfortable temperatures for our ride. So don't forget your jacket. You know, we better get a move on. It's getting darker the closer we get to Sasquatch Valley. And I suggest strongly that you keep a watch to the dark trail sides, where the trees get thick and tall, and the Sasquatches, they're going to be out there lurking and watching us. Hello, Nance. It's Jay again from Montana. First, I would like to say that I appreciate all the comments to my stories. I am glad you all enjoyed them. For me, however, they're not stories. They're a view into my life. Please know and understand, it's not like I'm some family member or that I am best friends with this Sasquatch family that resides close to where I live. It's just that we're like both trying to live in this world, and we're trying to make some sense out of it. I respect them and their lives, and they do respect me. Now, this is delicate and always must be handled by both parties with great care. I do find it hard to believe anyone who says that they're living with the Sasquatch like they're all one big family. People, it just doesn't work that way. And as I have said before, you will not find Sasquatch. Sasquatch will find you. And they will find you when you're most unprepared to come into contact with them. Now, here's just a thought for those going into possible Sasquatch territory. First, know the way in and know the way out. And don't expect that you will find Sasquatch. Don't try to force a situation like knocking on trees or banging some rocks together. That is their form of communication. And to them, it's not just banging rocks or some tree knocking. It's a form of communication, much like our writing. Now, we don't know what all that means, and really, I do know Sasquatch does not like it. As I have said, there are good and there are bad Sasquatch. Knocking on trees and banging rocks together really doesn't do anything for a human in regards to letting them know that you mean them no harm. They will know if you mean harm, just as we can tell if another human means us harm. And always, always carry a weapon if you are going to go into the forest. Carry a big weapon. In my experience, the mature Sasquatch, they know what a gun is, and they know what it can do. They do fear it, because even the big ones know they can be killed by one. Plus, if you're going into the forest, you should have something else besides just bear spray to protect you. I do not feel sorry for anyone who decides to go hiking in the woods and they get injured or killed by some wild animal because they didn't take some kind of real protection. With no protection, you're just setting yourself up to be a hot lunch for some animal. And if you think that walking around with a stick with some bells on it is going to save you and it's going to keep from startling some grizzly bear or some other huge predator, you should think again. All you're doing is ringing a dinner bell. And please, folks, do not think that you can hunt these amazing individuals down and kill them, because you can't, unless you get very lucky. Anyway, let me get to my story. I live in a city just a little north of Flathead Lake in Montana. The valley I live in is a very large valley called Flathead Valley. Our county is the biggest in Montana. In fact, it's bigger than most of the counties in the United States. Just to give you an idea, San Diego County in California, and I'll use that as an example because I spent 10 years there, Well, San Diego County has 3.5 million people living in that county. My county, Flathead County, it's more than twice the size of land, but only has about 150,000 people living in the whole county. And we are surrounded everywhere by mountains. I mentioned before that I've been looking into some very strange things. I know this is getting to be long, but all of this background is important. I have read many articles with great concern that many people, those especially in my neck of the woods and in the Glacier National Park, well, there's a lot of people that sometimes they just go missing. Now, understand that this is something that isn't really talked about, but we do have a feral people issue in some parts here. I don't mean that people who live in the forest like hillbillies or that they just reside in the woods. I'm talking about real feral people. People who are as wild and possibly as dangerous as any other big predator. So you're wondering, what does this have to do with Sasquatch? Well, when you hear what I'm about to say, just understand, I'm still having difficulty with what I saw on that day, and I'm still trying to understand and process it. So here goes. It was about 3 weeks ago, and I decided to go for a drive. I decided to head into an area that's a very dense forest area. It's just north of Sea Falls, going towards a backwoods town called Polebridge. And folks, I think when he says Sea Falls, he's meaning Columbia Falls there in Montana. He continues and he says, I wasn't 5 miles out of Sea Falls when I decided to pull over into a parking area that was right beside the North Fork River. Now, the area is a clear-cut area with large parking, bathrooms, and picnic tables. It's very near a shallow section of the river that at just about any time of the year, you can walk across the river there with water barely ankle high. The section of the river by this parking area has about a 100-yard section by about 30 feet wide with very dense forest on the other side. Black bears and some grizzly bears have been known to frequent this area, but nothing of consequence has ever really happened. Just know that I was unarmed at the time. So I get out of my rig and I'm just enjoying the day. It's about 20 degrees out, which is warm for the area at that time of year. I'm looking at the water flow and walking along this sort of muddy and frozen dirt shoreline. I'm looking at some tracks. I'm seeing big buck tracks, some wolf tracks, dog tracks. I mean, there are tracks everywhere. I'm looking and I'm just enjoying myself. Now I've walked about 70 yards away from my rig, and that's when I noticed something on the ground. It was a strange track that seemed very out of place. Can anybody guess what that track was? Well, wait for it. Surprise, surprise, it was not a Sasquatch track. It was, however, a barefoot human track. It was in a softer section of the mud by the river. The track appeared to come out of the water like whoever had made this track just walked right out of the water. Now I am there thinking, who's out here walking around in the river with the river temperatures this cold in what seems to be bare feet? Now I say it seems to look like bare feet. So I'm following these strange tracks that don't make any sense, and they looked really fresh. I mean very fresh. Now the tracks go for about 30 feet. Then they go up the bank into a clear-cut section. This clear-cut section was a very large section, a good 100 yards long and at least 75 yards wide to the main road. So I wasn't out in the middle of nowhere. But I lost the tracks as they went into this clear cut. And I call it a clear cut, but it wasn't clear cut like a logger had done it. No, it looked more like the trees were knocked over by heavy winds. They were very big trees, too. Some looked cut, but they had been left there for whatever reason. I have no idea. So as I'm looking ahead at that area, I see movement very clear, and I freeze. Then I see movement behind some brush and a tree with a very large circumference to it. First thing I thought, oh no, it's a bear. The movement was quick and calculating. I had no weapon, and now I'm about 80 yards from my rig, out in the open. I began to back up quietly and quickly. I backed up about 10 yards and stopped. Something popped its head over the big tree in front of me. Can you guess what it was? Well, no, it wasn't a bear, and neither was it a Sasquatch. It looked like a person. So I stopped all movement and just looked at what I am thinking is a human being. And this human being is looking right back at me. And more so, this human being looked like a woman, maybe late 20s, maybe early 30s. As I was looking at her, I was now more sure that I was looking at a human, and a human woman to boot. So I waved my hand and I said hello. Well, I thought I said hello loud enough that she could hear me. Mind you, she's only about 40 feet away. But I got no response. So I say hello again, this time a little louder. And again, I get no reply. She's just staring at me. Still at this point, I'm thinking nothing of it, and I was about to turn around and just walk away when she stood up. And I'm going to have to describe her because I got a very good long look at her. This definite woman was tall, close to as tall as me, if not taller. She was white. Her hair was very dirty and very tangled and long, down to her knees. She was wearing what looked like a full leather outfit, or maybe later when I was trying to process what happened, I thought maybe it was an animal skin. This garment, I guess you'd call it, went all the way down to her ankles, and it looked like she had a shirt or some kind of heavy long sleep shirt under her main garment. She was definitely dirty. She had a smooth face and some dark eyes. I mean, she was a human being. I'm looking at her for at least a couple minutes. Then she stepped out from behind the trees and stepped towards me. She did not have boots on, but she was wearing some kind of footwear on her feet, maybe like heavy-duty socks or something. Now, I don't know why, but I took a few steps back as she came out from behind the fallen tree. She did not advance further as we were both just looking at each other. Then I thought, oh, crap. This is one of those feral people. And know this, feral people are never by themselves. If you ever come across feral people in the forest, it is possible that they are dangerous, and there is always more than one. So I began to back up slowly, all the while saying things like, "Hello, how are you? Is there anything wrong? Do you need any help?" But I got no response. Do any of you remember how I said in my other email that the language of the Sasquatch, when they talk, that it sounds like English, but it's not English. It's more like Carney? Well, that's how she spoke. She spoke fast, and it sounded like English, but it wasn't. Now that caught me off guard. I was now backing up and moving, and she began to walk to me. I stopped, and she stopped. Then she turned her head towards the river, and she spoke again. Then she gave a whoop. I didn't think much of it right then, but about 4 seconds later, and I'm just saying 4 seconds to give you a sense of passing time, I really don't know how long it was, but it wasn't long. Anyway, about 4 seconds later, there was a whoop in reply. Then there was some kind of chatter back. Then she answered back with the same chatter. and out of the tree line stepped a Sasquatch. Now, as I've said before, Sasquatch are not cryptids to me because of how many times I've had the privilege to encounter these amazing individuals. But when I saw this, I stumbled and fell back, and I hit my head on something hard. Immediately, I tried to get back to my feet. But if you've ever gotten up really fast, say, after a nap or from sitting too long, and you got an instant feeling of being lightheaded, well, that's the feeling I got right then. And I fell back down, and I couldn't get back to my feet. I was conscious, but in a sort of daze. As I was lying there, I heard footsteps fast approaching. I didn't know who it was, but something grabbed me and moved me to a softer spot on the ground. I laid there for a minute, and then I felt cold water being poured on my head. That brought me fully awake. I got up to my feet. Then there was a kind of shriek. It was that woman who poured the water on me, and by getting up, I had startled her. She jumped back. And when I say she jumped back, I mean she jumped at least 10 feet. Then I hear another whoop and more of that chatter that seemed more guttural, and it was coming from across the river. But there wasn't anything over there. She moved back away from me very fast, and then she kind of growled at me. Not in a menacing way, but just a sound she made. Then she took off across the river, and she was gone from my sight in about 5 seconds. Now that's the story, and this is what is poking around in my brain. I said that we have a feral problem here where I live. I have seen these feral people on occasion because I'm part of a very well-organized, advanced, and highly experienced search and rescue team, and I have come across feral people in some of my searches. I have never had a direct aggressive encounter, but I do know that if I wasn't armed, and if I hadn't been with other people who also saw them, it possibly could have gotten very bad. So you do run across feral people. And when or if you ever do, err on the side of caution. Engage with them as you would any other wild animal. Make sure they know that you see them. Walk casually in the opposite direction, and never run. Now, back to the woman. I mention these feral people because I want to mention this, that there are some people who think that Sasquatch kidnaps young girls. I have read many accounts of this. Now, I cannot say if it's true or if I even believe it, but here's the thing. What if it is true? Now stay with me, because I'm going to say something that I can't even believe I'm going to say, but there is no explanation for what I experienced that day. Remember the story of the jealous Bigfoot? Remember my interaction with a young female and how I felt that a young female Sasquatch might have started to become attracted to me as a possible mate? Well, what if that woman that I saw had been kidnapped by a Sasquatch at a very young age? And I do mean a very young age. Maybe she was raised by the Sasquatch, and maybe she's either its mate or treated as its child. The Sasquatch that I saw, I believe, was male. Now, I'm not going to go into extra detail about what that Sasquatch looked like, because we all know what they basically all look like. And there wasn't anything special about his appearance, except that he had a head that was more round like a human, just a lot bigger. I know that my, well, let's call it a theory or messed up conclusion or what have you, but look, this woman spoke the Sasquatch language, I am sure. She had hair that was not kept up, and it was long, down to the shins of her leg. She wasn't wearing normal clothes. She whooped, and the Sasquatch whooped in reply. Then she replied to it, then took off in the direction that I'm assuming was where the Sasquatch was. Now, I'm going to go back there, and I'm going to explore the forest area across the river. And it's all Forest Service land, and there's lots of it. Well, that's all for that encounter. Let me know what you all think, because I still don't know what to think, and I'm just not understanding what it was that I was experiencing. Thank you again, Nance, for reading this story, and thank you, everyone, for listening. I have more stories to share, but this one was like nothing I have ever seen or experienced before. Signed, Jay. Well, that is an incredible experience, and it certainly gives some food for thought. I do know that many Native American tribes have repeatedly said for many centuries that Sasquatch are known to be stealers of men, women, and children. However, the reasons that they steal the men, women, and children seem to differ from tribe to tribe. Some say it's for cannibalistic reasons, some say it's to mate, others say they don't know. But it certainly gives you something to think about. I've heard of many reports of feral people, supposedly quite a few down in the Smoky Mountains. So who can say? Anything is possible in this world, isn't it? So, if you missed Jay's other email that he references in this one, I'll put a link to it in the video description below. I just want to say thank you for staying with me on this journey down into Sasquatch Valley tonight. And don't worry, keep your snackages up and ready, because we'll be meeting up again for another journey in just a couple days. And until then, always remember, absence of proof is not proof of absence. Thanks for listening.